So can we do other topic little bit for 10 minutes? Because we have time, okay? Let's do absorption of vitamin and minerals. So these are the, you can see these are the, we will talk about the, actually vitamins are not digested. There will not be digestion because vitamins are already in absorbable form. So there will be only the absorption of vitamins and minerals. So you can see a described parts of intestine. We will responsible for digestion and absorption of this. So we will talk about which part absorb what. And vitamins and minerals. We classify vitamins and minerals. Then we will talk about this vitamin. Specifically, we focus on vitamin B12 absorption. Then we will talk about calcium, iron, and Menkes disease. And then this acrodermatitis enteropathica, zinc absorption deficiency. So Menkes, we have already studied. This is actually copper deficiency. And this is zinc deficiency. So we will talk about this. You can see here this all, you can see this part of intestine and what is absorbed. So you can see, we can actually classify, let's classify first into minerals, into type. Vitamins, we already know. Fat-soluble vitamins and water-soluble vitamins, you already know. Let's classify these minerals. So minerals can be classified into two groups, bulk elements, and then you classify into trace elements. Trace elements. Okay, so bulk elements, what are bulk elements? Bulk elements are elements that are required in quantity more than 100 mg. And trace elements are elements which are required in quantity less than 100 mg. Very simple. What are bulk elements? You know, calcium is present in bone in about like 1 kg of calcium is present in your body. Between 0.5 kg to body. So calcium. Then phosphorus is also present with calcium. Calcium, phosphorus. Now you can see sodium. Sodium is also present in very high quantity. Potassium. And then chloride. These are present, and magnesium. So these are very present in magnesium, is also present in 400 mg. So among this is the list. So you can say these are bulk element. So we require in very high quantity. And trace elements are, you can say zinc, copper, iron, iodine, selenium, cobalt, molybdenum. So these are trace elements. These are trace elements. So if you can remember, it's easy to, if you remember this bulk element, this calcium with phosphorus, sodium, potassium, chloride, and then you remember magnesium. So these are all bulk elements. So you rest are trace. You can see this calcium, iron. Calcium, and then this calcium, iron, phosphorus. Calcium, phosphorus, iron, copper, magnesium. These mainly these minerals, and then vitamins. You can see most of the vitamin minerals and vitamins, they are absorbed from duodenum and jejunum. Okay, almost all vitamins and minerals are absorbed from duodenum and jejunum. Don't try to differentiate. Especially calcium is absorbed from duodenum. I told you to remember calcium 3D. About calcium. What is 3D? First is duodenum. Absorption in duodenum. Third, second, reabsorption in DCT. And then last is vitamin D. So this 3D is associated with calcium absorption. Vitamin D stimulates its absorption. So these are the vitamins and minerals that are absorbed from duodenum. Almost all vitamins, minerals are absorbed from duodenum and jejunum. Few vitamins, you can see vitamin B12 is absorbed from terminal ileum. Bile salt and B12, I told you, at least remember bile salt in the beginning, I told you B12 and bile salt, they are absorbed from terminal, actually ileum, actually terminal ileum. and this folate and vitamin D, other fat soluble, and this vitamin C absorbed from here. Actually, vitamin C keep absorbing from this jejunum. It will absorb here. These two are more important. Vitamin B12 and bile salt are absorbed from here. Okay, vitamin, bile salt or vitamin. All other vitamins are absorbed from duodenum and jejunum. So these are few. There are few things that will be actually absorbed from this stomach. You can see. And sodium, see this sodium chloride and potassium and water. These are absorbed from large intestine. Okay, these are absorbed from large intestine. So these are daily requirement. I have added one slide so that actually we are doing vitamins from the beginning only. Let's do little bit minerals also. That is why actually let's talk about this daily requirement of vitamins also, not minerals. I have told you a little bit. You can see this minerals. You can understand this bulk elements and trace elements. And vitamins, let's talk about the daily requirement of vitamins also. See, I will give you a very easy trick to memorize. You don't have to memorize this number. That is a good thing about us. What you need to remember is there are few vitamins that are required in microgram. So these vitamins are vitamin B12. And you can see folate. So vitamin B12 and folate, you know, these are hemopoietic vitamins. These hemopoietic vitamins are required in microgram. It's easy to remember. And other vitamins that are required for your energy are actually required in mg. From, you can see from top to bottom, it's required in mg. All water soluble vitamin, you can see it is required in mg. And then, you know, vitamin B2 will form FAD and FMN. And this FAD and FMN generally bond with the enzyme very tightly. It is tightly bond with the enzyme, FAD and FMN. And that is why this is required in very low quantity. FAD and FMN, they are bond with the enzyme very tightly. Vitamin B2 is tightly. They are generally prosthetic group. They are all prosthetic group. So therefore, this is required in very low quantity. And for vitamin B1, till now we have studied only four enzymes are there in our body that require vitamin B1. What are they? PDH. And that is also, this vitamin B1 is also prosthetic group. PDH, other alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase, alpha keto acid, alpha keto acid dehydrogenase. You can see branch chain alpha keto acid dehydrogenase. These are three are similar type of enzyme, E1, E2, E3 containing enzyme complex from B1 to B5. And fourth is transketolase. So these four enzymes are present associated with vitamin B1. And vitamin B1 is very tightly associated. That is why you can see vitamin B1 and vitamin B2 are present in very low quantity, 1 mg. So you can correlate, you can easily memorize this also. Just I am giving you very nice, you can easily memorize this way. And niacin, you know, NAD and NADP, they are actually not tightly bound. They are free in our cell and very required in very high quantity. And that is why you can see it is 15, about 5, 16. And panto means 5 and 5 mg. Everything is 5 here. Panto means 5, vitamin B5 and this 5. So it is easy to remember. So you can remember most of this. And biotin is also required in very micrograms. See, only this is biotin is in this requiring microgram. Why? Because biotin is also very tightly bound. It is also prosthetic group. Prosthetic group. We of four enzyme, four carboxylase. Okay? What is this pyruvate carboxylase? I'll write pyruvate carboxylase, acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase, propionyl coenzyme A carboxylase, PCC, and then methyl crotonyl coenzyme A MCCC, methyl crotonyl coenzyme A carbo. These four enzymes only contain this biotin, and that too in very tightly bound form. That is why this is required in very low quantity, B1, B2, and this B3, this biotin, they are very tightly bound. And vitamin C is the vitamin that is required in very high quantity. So will you able to memorize in rough way RDA, recommended daily allowances for vitamins? This is part of nutrition. Yes?
Yes, sir.
It is not difficult. It is very easy. B1, B2, biotin, very low quantity. And then niacin, high quantity. If you remember the metabolism, you can remember the daily requirement also. If you know little bit metabolism, you can easily remember RDA. Now, this RDA actually, just I want to tell you this, and then this RDA actually, you can say this, you can memorize yourself. I don't want to focus right now. So it is, because these are like new part of nutrition, it is good to know about recommended daily allowances for yourself also. How much vitamin is required so that you will able to plan diet for yourself also. If you see some level of this vitamin level, so you will understand how much vitamin is required for our body and what is there in level. If it is very low, so it cannot supplement all the vitamins. So you have to understand this. Now you can see minerals. I told you bulk elements. These are trace elements. Okay, bulk elements. These are bulk elements, you can see, because it is required in more than 100 gram. You can see it is required, and you don't have to remember individual. Just see. They all are required in more than 100. You can see this calcium. Calcium, it is not mg, okay? This is gram. This is gram. So this is, sorry. This is not gram. This is daily requirement is mg only. Actually, our body has about, you can see, 700 gram of calcium. Okay, about in between 500 to 1 kg of calcium and then phosphorus. So calcium and phosphorus is present in bone in very high quantity. And these are required in this quantity, more than 100 mg. You can see potassium, 2 gram. And sodium, you can see where sodium, 500 mg. So this is the requirement you can see. Anyway, more than 100 gram mg, is, just remember that. For this, less than 100 mg, around 10 mg, you can see almost all have requirement more around 10 mg and less than 10 mg, not 100 also, 10 mg, less than 10 mg. And this is actually two types. One require in mg, other requires in microgram. These are the ultra trace element. Very low quantity is required. Iodine, copper, chromium, molybdenum, they are required in very low quantity.